So Pete, I'm going to talk element widths for a second. I've heard that relative widths are better suited for responsive design. Why is that?
Sure. Let's take a look at this website for a second. It's got a beautiful panoramic image that's 1,200 pixels wide. On this laptop screen, where the viewport width is 1,280 pixels, no problem. The image fits just fine.
Right. But now, what happens if you shrink the browser to a size that's below the image's native width?
Yeah, if I'm not careful, instead of shrinking and rescaling the image will keep its original dimensions. Users will need to scroll left and right to see the whole image.
Oh, that's ugly and annoying.
Yeah, it's not a good experience. On the Nexus 7, about a third of the image is going to get cut off. But on something like an iPhone 5, the user's going to see less than half the image. They're going to have to scroll left and right to see the whole thing. Since CSS pixels vary so widely across all these different devices, you shouldn't count on a specific viewport width for your content to render well. Large CSS widths, or even absolute positions, can result in elements that are either too big or don't fit on the screen at all. This is why you should use relative positions instead of absolute positions, such as width 100%.